Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. Sony's PlayStation 4 will start shipping in the US and Canada on Friday for $399. Sony tried to simplify the hardware architecture of the PS4 to reduce the cost of the console while future-proofing it to last as long as 10 years. The PS4 has 8 x86 CPUs, codenamed Jaguar, made by AMD. In addition, enhanced graphics coprocessors, also made by AMD, can deliver 1.84 teraflops of performance. The game console has a 500GB hard drive with support for Blu-ray. It has 8GB of memory. More memory was demanded by game developers, so 176GB per second of bandwidth feeds the throughput. Microsoft's Xbox One, on the other hand, which is scheduled to ship next week, will cost $499, that's $100 more, and includes Kinect motion sensing hardware. Amazon has teamed up with the U.S. Postal Service to get you your purchases over the weekend. Sunday deliveries will be available to customers in the New York and Los Angeles metropolitan areas, and the service will expand to a large portion of the U.S. next year. Subscribers to Amazon Prime don't need to do anything differently to receive Sunday delivery. The $79 per year membership program already includes free two-day shipping, and orders placed on Friday will now show up on Sunday in supported areas. Motorola Mobility introduced the Moto G smartphone Wednesday, which is a lower-cost device with a 4.5-inch screen and a $179 price tag. The price is without a contract, which is a departure from the typical $500 to $600 cost of most smartphones. Cheaper smartphones sometimes sacrifice performance and quality, but company executives said that's not the case with the Moto G. The phone is powered by a 1.2 GHz quad-core processor from Qualcomm and has a 720p screen. It includes a 5-megapixel camera and options for 8 or 16 gigabytes of storage. On the software side, the device runs Android 4.3 with some minor customizations and will be upgraded to Android 4.4 by January next year. Motorola has worked to improve battery life, and users will also get 65 gigabytes of online storage. The phone goes on sale this week in parts of Brazil and Europe, and will be available within the next few weeks throughout Latin America, Europe, Canada, and parts of Asia. It will come to the US, India, and the Middle East in January. Our friends over at TechHive took a look at Olaclip's 4-in-1 lens for iPhone photography. Here's a look at their rapid review.
Olaclip was already one of the best iPhone photography accessories on the market, and the brand new one, they just made it better. It's a 4-in-1, it packs 4 lenses into the compact little add-on that you can take anywhere. This replaces the 3-in-1 system, so it's still got the same fisheye and wide-angle lens, but now there are 2 macro lenses instead of just one. The fisheye lens will capture a nearly 180-degree view, so it's great for panoramas and landscapes. The cool distortion is really fun to play with, too. The wide-angle lens also gives you a larger field of view like the fisheye lens does, but without that distortion. The 2 macro lenses do the opposite. They let you shoot extreme close-ups, showing you the textures and patterns of the objects you come across every day. It's kind of like a little microscope for your phone. The 10x is easy to use, but the 15x gets you almost too close. The Olaclip 4-in-1 isn't cheap, but it's so much fun to play with. And it can help you think about your iPhone like a serious camera. Olaclip is one of the best iPhone photography accessories on the market, and the brand new 4-in-1 version is even better than before. It packs 4 lenses into a compact little add-on that you can take anywhere.
A new air defense system successfully targeted, tracked, and destroyed 2 targets from opposite directions, something that's not typical of most systems. Tested at the White Sands Missile Range in New Mexico, the Medium Extended Air Defense System, or MEADS, consists of 3 separate mobile units. There's the 360-degree surveillance radar, which can acquire and track targets, a networked MEADS battle manager, and 2 launchers firing PAC-3 missiles. In the scenario, a QF-4 target drone approached from the south, while a ballistic missile came in from the north. The radar acquired both targets and provided target cues to the MEADS battle manager. 3 PAC-3 missiles were fired, with 2 aimed at the incoming missile and 1 at the target drone. The test was unique because the 2 targets were separated by more than 125 degrees, and the PAC-3 missile fired at the target drone had to radically change course once it was launched. MEADS is a joint project under development by Germany, Italy, and the United States, and has been undergoing tests since 2011. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. To find out what's coming up on every week's show, be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next week.